We all perform series of movements throughout our day, but we still don't really understand how those series of movements are organized. There's been this long-standing debate that series of actions might be organized as either a hierarchy, and you can think of this as having different levels of control, or they might be organized in a chain, and you can think of this as kind of like dominoes. You set up that first action, and it causes a cascade of subsequent actions.
Why is this important? Our study have provided very important insights in terms of how to treat disease, like a Parkinson's disease, which have problem with start or stop action, or the psychiatric disease like OCD, which have problem with switch from one motor program to another motor program.
What we did was we turned to mice because we can train mice to perform action sequences. And we also have all of these amazing tools and techniques, such as optogenetics, to actually turn on or turn off different cells in the brain. We designed a task for the mice. You can think of this like playing the piano for humans. Instead of playing notes on the piano, they're playing a series of lever presses. And what they do is they perform this series of lever presses to receive a little treat at the end. We could actually use optogenetics to activate different cells in the brain while animals perform this sequence. And by disrupting the behavior in a very precise way, we could investigate how the sequence was organized. What we found is that in the striatum, which is this area of the brain that's part of the basal ganglia, thought to be heavily involved in movement, it's classically believed that different pathways in the striatum function in opposition to control movement. But what we found is that actually there was more complexity to how these two pathways are behaving.
In this particular study, we provide conclusive evidence suggest that learned action sequence is actually organized in a hierarchical manner, but not in a series chain. And more importantly, we found a cells in the brain structure called striatum. There are different cells responsible for different level of behavior, meaning they work together and are complementary to control the behavior hierarchy.
I hope that down the road this will have important implications for individuals that struggle with properly performing action sequences such as Parkinson's or Huntington's disease, or individuals that have difficulty transitioning to new actions, like those with obsessive compulsive disorder who often have trouble switching to new things.
I'm particularly excited about the study because it solved a long standing debate in the field. At the same time, it provides new insight for potential treatment for the different neural disease.